All right, so we're figuring out how we know this stuff makes sense. Now we're going to look at the trigonometry of Pythagorean identities. Pythagorean means 90 degree triangle. So I'm going to model it off of something that looks like a unit circle. This might not be a unit circle, doesn't matter. The fact is that I've got a triangle delivered within a circle here, drawn within a circle. Okay, I just pulled it out here. So normally we have our angle, our x, which is our left, right, and our y's are up, down, and our radius. Well, I'm going to describe this as, there's our question angle of question, there's our adjacent side, opposite side, and hypotenuse side. Now, what we know about Pythagorean theorem, right, is that it goes like this, a squared plus b squared equals c squared, where c is the hypotenuse, and those are the legs. So, you know, grade 9 stuff, nothing new here. Well, I'm going to rename that to be opposite, adjacent, and hypotenuse, okay? So there's opposite squared plus adjacent squared equals hypotenuse squared. Okay, well, that's fine, but we want to talk about trig identities. So we have to turn those into trig identities. Remember, that's like sine, cosine, tangent, cosecant, all that stuff. So how am I going to do that? Well, those are all ratios. Sine is a ratio, opposite over hypotenuse. Cosine is a ratio, adjacent over hypotenuse. And tangent is a ratio of sine or opposite over adjacent. Okay. Now, what I'm going to do is draw your attention to this one thing here. This here, if I had, for example, 3 squared plus 4 squared equals 5 squared, which we know is true, that's a perfect triangle, I could also say, would you agree with that? Yes, we would agree with that. Okay. All I'm doing is dividing it by the same number. Okay, now you chose one because really one won't change the value of what this is. Okay, but the thing I want to highlight is that this number is the same as this number is the same as this number. So what that tells me, that's within the brackets here, I could divide that by x and whatever, I should have picked a different letter, but some variable, and this equal sign will still remain true, okay? Some unknown value, we can call it anything, okay? I'll draw my chalk brush. So what I'm gonna do is, in order to get trig identities, like cosine and sine, I'm gonna divide each of these by the hypotenuse, okay? Whatever it is, okay? Now, of course, because we're dividing by the same, this will remain true, and that's what we're going for. So I will show that up here. Instead of just having opposite, I'm going to have opposite over hypotenuse squared. And instead of adjacent by itself, I'm going to have adjacent over hypotenuse squared. Oops. Equals, and this will be hypotenuse over hypotenuse squared. Okay? As you can see, it's divided by the same numbers, therefore this equal sign will remain true just like the other cases. Now, opposite over hypotenuse, that's sine. Okay, plus sign is still there. Adjacent, this is cosine. Notice where I'm putting my 2, it's on the outside there. Equal sign is still there, and h over h is 1 squared. Okay? 1 squared is just 1. Okay? Anyway, so this proves, or this shows our Pythagorean trig identity here. We take a regular triangle, that's our Pythagorean theorem, we pop in opposite adjacent hypotenuse, we change the value of this without disrupting the truthiness of the equal sign, it's still true, and then we realize that we can rewrite it as this plus this equals this. Another way to write this, you will see the 2 is on the outside here, is this, sine squared theta plus cos squared theta equals 1, okay? Be familiar that these are the same thing, just a different way of writing it, okay? But, here you go. Just that easy. Okay, the next video I'm going to show you how to maneuver this equation around a little bit.